Windows Snap is as fundamental to Windows as, say, Windows. Today, we're going to tell you how to take it to the next level with Fancy Zones. So by now, you should have used Windows Snap, but if you haven't, let me give you a quick tutorial. In Windows, of course, all we do is on a daily basis is open windows, close windows, resize windows, and with Snap, it's very easy to take a window, such as a web browser right here, and pin it to one side or another. That allows you to open up another window over here to the side, which allows you to essentially double your monitor space for the price of one screen. I use this all the time, even on multiple screens, as it allows me to see more things at once. With Snap, of course, you can go ahead and pin things to either side. You can actually go ahead and pin these to a corner as well, which gives you an interesting sort of arrangement like this, where you have three windows on the screen at once. But with this, though, you can see the limitations of what we're looking at. So, for example, with this Bing window down here below, you can't really see a whole lot. Ditto with this window up here on the side. It might be better if we were to use columns instead of little tiny rectangles. Now, we can do this with a new tool called Fancy Zones. And Fancy Zones is actually an app within PowerToys. Now, if you're a longtime Windows user, dating back to Windows XP or Windows 7, you might be familiar with PowerToys. In fact, with Windows XP, there were apps that would allow you to essentially turn anything that was not an audio CD into an auto-playable CD. And with PowerToys, Microsoft's rebooted it for the Windows 10 generation. So this is a pre-release piece of software, and you have to actually download it on GitHub. But once you do that, you get the PowerToys menu. And in fact, it's going to live way down here on the taskbar. And in fact, PowerToys actually has two separate apps, both of which need to be turned on. There's Fancy Zones here, and then there's a shortcut guide here. The shortcut guide is essentially a quick overview that if you hold down the Windows key for a minute or two, or sorry, a second or two, you get this sort of this list of shortcuts. But PowerToys is really, Fancy Zones is really what we're interested in right now. Once we're in the general settings, we can actually launch Fancy Zones from the left-hand nav bar here. And we're immediately faced with a number of different configuration options. We'll talk about those a little bit later, but for right now, we can launch the edit zone, or the zone editor, by hitting this button here, or going ahead and hitting the Windows plus the tilde key. And you can see that it's hiding behind the menu. It's a little bit quirky, but here we are with the options. Now we have two options here. We can go ahead and use templates, which we're going to go ahead and look at first, or we can go ahead and create a custom layout. Now, the custom templates allow you to go ahead and use, say, this focus, which is sort of this, you know, windows stacked on top of each other, columns, rows, grids, or priority grids, which again gives you sort of a bit of a focus on that center column. You can go ahead and adjust the numbers here by adding or subtracting, and when you're ready, let's go ahead and use columns. We can apply them. Now, what you should see, and what we've seen before, is that when we use the Windows key, we can go ahead and move these things around on the screen, and we get a nice columned look where we can go ahead and scroll on each. We can go ahead and copy from one another. You can see this would be quite useful in, you know, say, writing a paper or something of that sort, where you're sort of looking at one web page and referencing it to another. So you can, of course, go back into the configuration menu and the zone editor, and actually switch if you'd like to give you a rows or priority grids and so forth. We're not going to do that right now. Instead, we're going to look at the custom templates, which are on the separate page. Now, custom templates can be performed in two different ways. You can actually create one additively, which is, say, basically from nothing, where you're putting sort of Windows zones on the screen and resizing them and basically creating your own custom layout. Or you can do it subtractively, which is to basically say, all right, I want to have an existing template and I just want to modify it, perhaps even just get rid of a zone, for example. Then you can do another one. So let me just go ahead and show you what it looks like when you actually create one additively. This is the custom layout I've done earlier. And you can see that right now we've got it sort of everything arranged in such a way. And in fact, the windows should arrange by themselves. If we go back into the zone editor and actually just edit the selected layout, you can see that these different windows, in fact, let me just move this sort of off a away from each other. These zones can be modified. I can drag them out. I can go ahead and close them, get rid of them using this X button. There's modifications where you can go ahead and create a little bit of space in between or thicken the borders, for example. And this should show up on the screen when you're actually creating a custom layout. Of course, you can go ahead and save it if you want and apply it to the windows on the screen. And again, you know, if you're switching between different layouts, you can adjust the windows as you wish. So that is the basics of creating a layout. Now again, there are different settings to go ahead and adjust. There's a few of them, and I don't necessarily think they're the most intuitive by default. For example, I like the fact that I want to go ahead and override Windows Snap hotkeys, the Windows plus the arrow key, to go ahead and move windows between zones. Others people might not want to. Microsoft thinks that you might not want that either. You can go ahead and keep windows in their zone when the screen resolution changes. You can flash the zones, which I think is great when you change the layout and so forth. These are all pretty useful. There's one thing down here that's worth knowing about as well, and that is there's options to play with fancy zones when you're adjusting the multiple desktops. Windows allows you, of course, to play with multiple desktops in task view. You can use fancy view zones with that. There's one catch to this all, and one thing that can improve. Fancy Zones only works on the default window, the active window. So if you're using multiple monitors, you're only going to get Fancy Zones on a single monitor at this point in time. It's the active one. I use my laptop as the active monitor. I've had to move it to my actual secondary monitor. That's fine. I expect this to be improved in the future, but for right now, it's not. So just keep that in mind. In any event, though, that's pretty much Fancy Zones in a nutshell. I expect, again, this will improve over time, but for right now, this is a fundamental change in Windows and one I think you will appreciate.